Now, we know that approximately 50% of the epilepsies have no treatment. So around 5 or 6 years ago, there was a movement to look for other alternative treatments. And you've probably heard that there's a big interest nationally in marijuana-based products. So we did a study to look at the effects of CBD in one of these rare epilepsies called Angelman syndrome. Basically, if you have this mutation, children will have developmental delay, they'll have intractable seizures, and it's lifelong. And we showed that CBD was effective in a model, an animal model, a mouse model, that had been mutated to replicate the human condition. We showed that it was quite effective in seizures, in development, in autistic features. One of the thoughts is that CBD, cannabidiol, has, quote, anti-inflammatory effects. But no one's really shown this. So in this same paper, what we did was we took cells from this mouse and we cultured them. What we then did was we measured the brain activity. What we found was that in these neurons, the bursting was abnormal. We know that these bursting oscillations lead to seizures, but they also change the architecture of the network. So where does CBD come in? Well, it turns out that what's creating this bursting is something called tau. It's basically the protein that keeps the integrity of the nervous system at the neuron level together. So when tau becomes hyperphosphorylated, it begins to recruit inflammatory cells. What you see is that when you put CBD on there in certain concentrations, it calms it down just like you would, just like you're using a fire extinguisher. It completely calms it down. It enables the brain, which is the brain wants to do, to recompensate, to reset, to form these new connections again. So what do we do with the information? Stay tuned. CBD is coming. People are now recognizing there's an opportunity here. You're going to see more CBD-based products come out in other areas like Alzheimer's. On the other end, you're also seeing an emergence of new approaches for these disorders. The way we practice probably in 20 years is going to be very different than what we practice today.